I love when a company releases a statement or announces something new on a Friday. It's the end of the work week, people going into their weekends, getting ready for F&M, maybe, for now. It's a PR move. Release something controversial on a Friday, you don't get as much pushback as you would if you released it on a Monday. It's clever, but you start to notice when they do it over and over again. Wizards of the Coast just made one of those announcements. Quote, "One of the core tenets of our fan-focused strategy is to make sure we deliver Magic to players when, where, and how they want it. For example, Magic has long been available on Amazon from various stores and distributors, but we formalized a direct relationship with Amazon in the United States to give players who order their product through that channel a better experience. To that end, Magic will also be available directly online from Walmart and Target in the United States as well. The goal here isn't to divert customers to these channels, it's to meet the customers who are already there and give them a better experience. A formalized relationship gives us the ability to better distribute product to players who aren't lucky enough to live near one of the many awesome local game stores. Basically, Wizards is selling directly to Amazon, Walmart Online, and Target Online. Let's talk about why that's a horrible idea by taking all of Wizards' quotes and challenging them. We'll start with, quote, for example, Magic has long been available on Amazon from various stores and distributors, but we formalized a direct relationship with Amazon in the US to give players who order their product through that channel a better experience. On the surface, this sounds fine, until you realize you just pooped all over various stores. Local game stores sell on Amazon Marketplace. The previous sales Wizards are referring to, those are from stores or distributors. Companies they sell to currently that help stock stores. These LGSs and distributors are selling on Amazon Marketplace in an attempt to make some money from rising box and pack prices. What do you think is going to happen now that Amazon has a direct hold on Magic product? Probably the same thing that's happened to D&D product on Amazon. It'll be sold at barely above distributor pricing. Amazon has never had to honor MSRP. Why would they start now? Putting this in place shoves distributors and local game stores out of a potential market, and worst of all, undercuts the rest of the internet. Look at TCGplayer.com. That's the biggest marketplace for Magic product, right? Thousands of local game stores sell sealed product on TCGplayer. Right now, Boxes of Guilds of Ravnica are around $90 there. That's pretty dang low. That's a slim margin. But it's where people who don't have local game stores can go to buy cheap sealed product online. And they buy it directly from a local game store they help to support, so at least the money stays in the community. But when Amazon starts undercutting even $90, there isn't a single local game store that can fight that. Amazon doesn't need to make anything above a razor-thin margin on sealed Magic product because they have the inventory, rate of sale, and capital to sustain themselves forever. Local game stores can't do that. There isn't enough inventory or rate of sale to make that feasible, which means these stores will sell less boxes. They will get less boxes from distributors. The distributors make less money because they don't need as many boxes. It's a snowball down a mountain kind of situation. So as someone who attends local game store, how will your life change? Is this even going to impact you at all? Maybe, eventually. Again, margins are already crazy low, and Amazon is going to undercut everyone online, which means that profit avenue is gone. This is going to push stores into diversifying their offerings even more. Why focus on Magic if it isn't going to make you any money? Quote, local game stores, especially the stores who participate in the Wizards Play Network, are vital to Magic and to Wizards of the Coast. They provide great play experiences, fun places to shop, and are a center for the gaming community. This is a quote from that same announcement. What Wizards fails to mention is that Magic events make stores no money at all, zero. Add that to the fact that stores will no longer be able to sell reliably on Amazon and maybe even TCG Player 2, and you're just asking for stores to stop ordering Magic product or order way less. If you want a fun shopping experience, you have to give the store something for it. Booster box value sucked already, but at least stores found ways to make money online, to help themselves out. But not anymore. And it isn't even Amazon who's the culprit, it's Wizards of the Coast coming in and even saying that they're replacing stores and distributors, as if that's some good thing that won't take money out of the Magic community and put it into the Amazon black hole. It feels like stores are being squeezed from every side. They barely make any money from boxes as is, and then WotC directly undercuts them. They're supposed to make money from buying and selling singles, right? but online buy lists make that a chore, and they don't have enough incentives to bring people into stores for events besides pre-releases, right? Running a local game store and trying to focus on Magic at all seems almost futile, and this is what really bothers me. Stores being able to sell boxes online on places like the Amazon Marketplace were able to make a bit of money to help keep their shops open for competitive players for Friday Night Magic, to also help them stock sleeves or dice bags or play mats, accessories of any kind, really, to help them foster a physical community. But it doesn't seem like that support is there as much anymore, and that's super dangerous, because organized play is the cornerstone of Magic the Gathering, isn't it? Sure, most players are casual and play at home, but they aren't the ones who spend the most money. They aren't the ones drafting every week, or playing in standard events, or going to PTQs held at stores. While competitive and casual competitive players make up a minority of the player base, they sure as heck make up a non-zero amount of the economic base. Most of my friends play casually, and they don't buy new sets that often. They buy secondhand singles for Commander or casual decks, mostly. Maybe a box every once in a while to draft themselves, but they're not the ones showing up every week and dropping $15 to draft at a local game store. The competitive players and players who enjoy the physical community are. And isn't that the entire selling point of Magic? Oh, hey, this game is great. It has an awesome community. Get some cards. Come down to a store. Play with your friends. Meet new friends. Hang out in a safe place and enjoy the game. Pushing local game stores as places to play Magic while also letting Amazon sell boxes directly at whatever margin they want are contradictory. Which brings us back to one of my main points. Why would stores keep bothering to sell Magic product after this? They're being pushed from all sides. Why keep trying when the margins are either way too thin or they just straight up lose money on hosting events? Think about it. What's the point? And that's what I'm worried about. Because if stores stop supporting Magic events, the competitive scene starts to dwindle. That's just true. If the competitive scene starts to dwindle, the economy falters. If the economy falters, no one's going to want to spend money on the game, and consumer confidence takes a nosedive. At this point, for many stores, it feels like they can only support Magic at a loss, or at such a thin margin, it isn't worth it. Wizards says they care about local game stores. But you can't do that while simultaneously taking a revenue route straight away from them. Before I'm done ranting, there's one last quote I want to fight. Quote, "We must meet gamers where they are if we want to show them how great Magic truly is. And for many WPN stores out there, our efforts to grow Magic will come back to you in the form of more players." I don't think this is true at all. What do you mean meet gamers where they are? They're on the internet. That's where they are. When I search where to buy Magic the Gathering cards on Google, this is what comes up. This, TCG Player, first in line. The marketplace where stores sell product. You want to meet gamers? Advertise on Google. No one needs Amazon for that. If someone wants to buy Magic cards, they can easily from any of the Magic community-based stores easily found here, or Magic Card Market. As for their second point, claiming that more players will go to their local game stores, do you think this will happen before or after stores stop supporting Magic as much? And since most players are casual to begin with, why would they go to a store when they can keep buying product online? I'm not saying there won't be any growth at all, but the downsides for that growth seem way too high. You're saying in exchange for the possibility of more players, local game stores have to be okay with being undercut even more than they already are. That's a bad deal. That's a really bad deal. At the end of the day, here's my point. Magic the Gathering has always been available online to anyone in the world who wants it. It's been on Amazon all over the globe, but from distributors and stores. By cutting in front of them and under them, you're not offering Magic to more people. The same people are seeing Magic, but now you're cutting out the middleman who runs the events, the middleman who takes care of local players, and the middleman who's the foundation of the entire organized play system. This entire thing seems hollow and seems like a cash grab to me. This isn't helping anyone besides Wizards of the Coast bottom line and Amazon. We need to support local game stores if we want organized play to stick around, whether that's in the store itself or online via a marketplace where they can sell their products. If Wizards wants stores to stay open and actually profit from the game, they need to put their money where their mouth is. It's really as simple as that. This video is brought to you in part by TCGPlayer.com. Hey, want to support a local game store? You can pre-order Guilds of Ravnica booster boxes right now on TCGPlayer for only $91 each. It's a great price. You get to support a store that cares about the community. Pick whichever you like. There are tons of them, like thousands. Enjoy being a part of the best community in the world. Amazon sucks. Get some boxes. Love ya. Enjoy. We'll be right back.